Welcome back to Janette's Strictly Peak. Thanks so much for tuning in. Lots of things to talk about this week. I had a pretty exciting week. First thing I want to talk about is Gregory Porter. I am a huge Gregory Porter fan, and Ali Ash and I got invited to go to a private concert that he held for Macmillan Cancer Research, and it was hosted by Magic FM. And we got to go, and there was only 70 people there, and we were one of the 70. We had the best time.
So we are about to watch Gregory Porter.
Yes.
Yes, thank you for the lighting. And we're so excited, we're inside a chapel. Look how cool. Whoa. Can't wait to watch. Bye. All these bad times
I'm going through just this. Every year, once a year, at the Royal Albert Hall, the best of the best Latin and ballroom dancers come together to compete for the international championship title. And I got to go this week with Daisy and a few of the other dancers to watch the competition. It was a magical night of dancing.
Hi everybody, we're at the Royal Albert Hall and we're watching the international. What are we watching? International. Those aren't the professionals, those are lots of people having a lovely time on the dance floor in the Royal Albert Hall. But we're about to watch the final, the big moment of all the professional couples. It's insane in here. All the outfits are so much glitter, feathers, and a lot of good footwork.
Here this year, not down there.
Shut up, professionals, you're incredible.
Oh my god, it's Karen Hardy.
That was an incredible samba.
One of the best parts of doing Strictly Come Dancing is being able to do the professional group numbers that we do on the Sunday Results Show. We get to work with some incredible choreographers from all over the world. And I thought it would be nice for you guys to get to meet some of them. Hello.
Hi there. I'm Bill, this is Kylie, my wonderful assistant, and we are actually choreographing a tribute to Rodgers and Hammerstein.
For Movie Week.
Yeah, for Movie Musicals Week. Yeah. Huge routine with loads of different styles. Ballet, Fosse, Astaire.
What's up everybody, I'm Christopher Scott, here in London town working on Strictly Come Dancing. It's been amazing for me, it's my second year. I did last year, two numbers, and it was really, really a special time out here, so I'm really glad that they brought me back. Our first one's tomorrow, this year. I got two more this year. First one is tomorrow. It's going down. I'm getting nervous. I'm getting butterflies.
Okay, my name is Matt Flynn. I'm a choreographer on the show. I've worked on the show for 5 years now. I do the group numbers with the pros and the celebrities, and the opening launch with the pros and the celebrities, their very first dance.
Hi, my name is Jenny Thomas, and I've been working on Strictly now for 11 years. This is my 11th year. I started on the show as a performer doing Lindy Hop, and then coaching some of the couples with their routine.
Hello, I'm Jason Gilkerson, and I'm the creative director of choreography on Strictly Come Dancing, and it's movie week, so this is like my favorite week of the year. So I hope you're watching, and
Now it's not just these incredible choreographers that come in and do the pro numbers and that have to choreograph for the show. Us professional dancers do it as well, and we have to try and come up with routines every week that not only show off the celebrity as much as we can, but also tell a good story so that the viewers like yourselves at home can enjoy the show. I spoke to some of the celebs and asked them what they think makes a good piece of choreography.
Okay, so choreography is the core of all dancing. In my view, the little I've learned since I've been doing Strictly is that you need a lot of content. You need to do the content in so much as it will enhance the person you're dancing with. Not be too difficult, not be too simple. And that's why you workshop everything together and you get a choreography which suits both of you. Especially if you're a celebrity, maybe who's never danced, you need it to be something you can do. But choreography, that's the basics of all dancing. I'm loving it.
I love it when AJ choreographs my routine because he makes it very exciting and he makes it very hard.
I love Oti's choreography. I love how musical it is and how
much it actually makes sense when you think about it. And then to be able to actually do the routine once we finally can, there is no better feeling than doing those moves to that music. She's a genius in every way. You all are, all you dancers, all over the world. I love you all, thank you for your moves.
I think that good choreography is key in performing a really good dance because it gives the dance life, and it also allows us as the celebrities to really feel through all of the movement and learning. You know, you have to have a lot of basic, you have to have a lot of sparkle in there, and the choreography is everything, and I'm so grateful I've got the best choreographer.
Now, although I'm not competing anymore in the competition, I still get to watch everybody from Claudia's area and enjoy the show. But because I'm in Claudia's area, I definitely still need to be Strictlified, don't I? And my Strictly Glam squad did an incredible job this weekend, but there was a moment where I had a little bit of a back and forth.
We've decided.
Yes. This is the look for tonight.
It's the look, isn't it?
Yeah, the look for tonight.
We all agree this is the look for tonight.
You've never looked better.
Never looked better. But then I threw my caution
to the wind. In terms of eliminations, this week was a very interesting week. We had Will Young, unfortunately, drop out of the competition for personal reasons, so him and Karen will no longer be competing. And we also had our third couple leave through the dance-off, which was Naga and Pasha. They did an incredible Charleston, dressed as a mermaid, which I really enjoyed, but unfortunately, when they were up against Anastasia and Brendan's Roomba, they didn't survive the dance-off. Naga's an incredible woman, I will miss her loads backstage, but I'm sure that we will stay friends and keep in touch. See the lightning. I know this anger's heaven sent. Well, guys, that's it for this week's Janette Strictly Peek. Thank you so, so, so much, as always, for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned a little bit more of the stuff that happens backstage. And I will see you guys next week. Keep dancing. Bye.